The replay of this game is brought to you by the friendly staff at Hometown Pharmacy. Hometown Pharmacy is the one stop in Doniphan for all your medical needs. Everything from vaccinations, to vitamins and supplements, to medical equipment, and medications. Refills can be requested online or by using their mobile app, and deliveries are available within the city limits. Hometown Pharmacy, proudly supporting the Dons and Donettes this season. Come experience the difference a Hometown Pharmacy makes.
And now for your starting lineups.
The Poplar Bluff Mules will be dressed in black uniforms, trimmed in maroon and white. They are the Mules. And they're coached by Will Durden. And they will go from left to right here in the first half as you look at your radio dial or if you're watching on the internet. And the Dons will be in their home whites trimmed in black and gold. And they will go from right to left here in the first half, coached by Adam Carpenter.
Will Elmore feet.
There's a nice crowd on hand here tonight for this Doniphan Poplar Bluff matchup. And not really all that many people here for Poplar Bluff. Big crowd on hand on their feet here as the Dons are being introduced. Clay Martin, Brad Edmonds, Austin LaRue, Justin Harder, and Lucas Moe rounds out the starting five for Coach Carpenter. It's Francisco, Leach, Lucas, McCain, and Houston for Poplar Bluff. Poplar Bluff, I think, a Class 5 school, and Don's Class 3, but they've been playing each other for the last several years. And they meet here, they switch off every year. Next year, they'll be, if they stay playing each other, it'll be at Poplar Bluff. Pretty big height advantage here for Poplar Bluff. And let's see, we got Justin Harder's going to be jumping against Willie Lucas. And we're just about ready to go here at the Bill Elwright Gymnasium in Doniphan. 8 minutes on the clock. And let's see. Ball in the air. And the tip is tipped into the back court, Poplar Bluff. And it's picked up by Marcidas Leach. He's a tall, lanky lefty. Gives it to McCain on the right wing. Dons are starting out man-to-man. Harder's got the job of guarding Lucas inside. And Lucas Moe is guarding Marcidas Leach. A lot taller. Leach gives it to Lucas. Now he hands it off to Houston. I'm sorry, they had a couple of the wrong numbers down there, so I've got to get used to the ones that were wrong. Leach, good defense here by the Dons. We've already played 35 seconds. Poplar Bluff hadn't got a shot off yet. Well, they missed Lucas. He was wide open inside. Now they get it to him. And he goes up, and he's fouled by Clay Martin. And Martin got caught on him on a switch. And Clay Martin picks up an early foul here with 43 seconds in. And Lucas will go to the free throw line for Poplar Bluff. Lucas and Leach both are left-handed. And he misses the first one and comes up short. I believe Frankie Castile, the announcer for one of the Poplar Bluff stations, give me some stats. I believe Leach and Lucas. Lucas does get the second one, and someone else. Francisco all shooting above 80% from the free throw line. A couple of them were up around 85. Full court pressure, and the ball to Austin LaRue up ahead. Lucas Moe dribbles into the paint, spin move up off the glass, and good. Moe took it to the hole and scored. Dog did a good job of that at Twin Rivers the other night. A little more height there, a little more athleticism, but he got it to work. Houston gives it to Lucas. He's open 15 on the baseline. That's good. Willie Lucas gets the first 3 points for Poplar Bluff, and McCain knocks the pass out of bounds. Well, Poplar Bluff really kind of a young team here. They start a freshman, two sophomores, a junior, and a senior. Brad Evans gets the inbounds pass from Barton. Back to Barton on the right side. He's going to shoot a three way long. And a rebound comes down to Houston, and he brings it into the front court for the Mules. They lead 3-2, 6.5 minutes left in the first quarter. Now Leach, and he's going to shoot a long three, no good. And nothing but white shirts there. Evans gets the rebound for the Dons. Quickly into the front court, Justin Harder. Gives it to Barton. Barton into the paint. Out in the corner, Austin LaRue for three. Harkin shot's good. Good job by Barton to find LaRue open in the corner. The Dons lead 5-3. Houston gives the ball to Lucas way out at the volleyball line. Now to Francisco, and we got a holding foul, a little hand check on Austin LaRue. That's his first and second team foul on the Dons already here. We played 2 minutes. It's 5-3 in favor of the Dons. Francisco will throw it in. Throws it in to McCain. Takes the shot, takes it to the hole, and he muscles it up and in. You can tell. I bet you McCain's a football player. He's a wide body. LaRue bounces ahead to Moe. Moe on the left side. Bounces in the paint. Harder with a left-handed layup. Good. He was cutting the paint. And it's 7-5 in favor of the Dons. A good start here. Now Lucas on drive baseline. And he goes up and he scores. He almost stepped out of bounds down there, but I guess he kept that big foot in. Barton quickly into the front court. Dribbles down, stops and pops in and out. And Lucas with a rebound. Gives it to Houston. Houston quickly into the front court. Dribbles to the right wing. Hesitation move. Goes baseline. Back to Lucas on the wing. Wide open underneath is Francisco, and he puts it up. He missed it. And LaRue got the rebound, and he blocked Francisco out, and Francisco picks up the foul. Good job there by Austin LaRue on defense and blocking out as well. And with the score tied 7-7, 5:13 to go in the first quarter. Poplar Bluff backs up out of that press. Don's got a couple of easy buckets out of it. Coach Durden is pulled out of it. Poplar Bluff playing man-to-man. Lucas Moe right wing. Out front to Harder. Swings it left side to Barton. And he's got a layup, and he lays it up and in. He took the ball to the hole, and good things here happen when you take the ball to the hole. Don's found that out Friday night at Twin Rivers. McCain dribbles baseline, and he loses it on the way up, and it should be the Don's ball. It does, just slipped out of his hand. And number 24, Colby Best, a 6-foot junior, is coming in for Francisco. And the Dons have the ball now. Now they're still man-to-man. Best will be guarding Barton now. Barton comes into the front court, dribbles to the center of the court. Gives it to Lucas Moe. Harder to Barton, three on the way, it's good. 5 points for Barton, and Coach Durden calls a timeout. The Don's off to a great start as they lead the Poplar Bluff Mules 12-7, 4:25 to go in the first quarter. We'll take a 30-second break, and we'll be back. Stay with us. Minutes and 25 seconds left to go in the first quarter, and the Dons have jumped out to a 12-7 lead over the Poplar Bluff Mules. And one thing I like to see here, a lot of times early in the game the Dons don't have but a couple of players scored. They've already had four guys scored here in less than half of the first quarter. But it'll be Poplar Bluff's basketball. Best will throw it in. Gets it into Leach. I'm telling you, he is a tall, thin drink of water. Gives it to Houston out front. Crosses the timeline. Dribbles over to the left side. Gives it to Leach on the left wing. Little jab step. And he carries the basketball. And they call it on him. He started to go from right to left there. And he brought that ball over and got his hand underneath the basketball. He looked at the official like, you're not supposed to call that. Austin LaRue's open for a three on the right wing. And no air ball. Lucas Moe gets it underneath, goes up, no good, but he's fouled. Good job by Moe there up in the trees. And that one's on Willie Lucas. That's his first, and it'll be the first free throws coming up for the Dons here. Lucas Moe, who has got 2 points. And the free throw's up and good. That makes it 13-7 in favor of the Dons. Next one on the way, and nothing but net for Lucas Moe. Give him 4 points, and it's 14-7. Inbounds pass comes to Bess. He gives it to Lucas, and Lucas at 6'6", bringing the ball up the floor. Spin move on Harder, and then he's cut off, and he kind of lost a handle on it, but it went right to Bess. Over to Houston on the left wing. Now back out to Leach. Leach dribbles back to the left wing. Still got his dribble live. Goes to the baseline and tries to pass into the middle. Stolen by the Don. Moe's going in on Best, and he lays it up, and he missed it. Ball tipped up and in. I don't know if that's LaRue or Harder. I think I'm going to give it to Harder. And it's 16-7, and Leach takes it into the paint, lays it up, no good, but we got a foul on the Dons. and it's on Lucas Moen. You could tell Leach had decided he was going to take that one to the basket no matter what happened. He had put his head down. He was going. He probably don't like the way the start of this one's gone here with the Dons on top 16-7. Long way to go, though. Leach makes the free throw, and that's his first point. As Rodney Houston checks out, and Tristan Francisco comes back in. And Leach makes both free throws. I don't think you want to put them on the free throw line very much from what I've seen on those free throw stats. 3:15 to go first quarter. Dons lead the Mules 16-9. Now Poplar Bluff's in a 1-2-2 zone. Moe fakes the three, takes it into the paint. Little jump hook up, won't go. And the rebound comes down to Tristan Francisco. Passes up in the front court to Leach. Leach, oh, what a move there. Buddy, good defense there by Eddins, but they missed the, didn't block out Willie Lucas on the, he got the rebound, put it back in. That makes it 16-11. It was good defense there. Leach made a heck of a move, but Eddins stayed with him. Austin LaRue out front, gives it to Moe. Moe cross court to Eddins. Eddins long three-pointer on the way, no good. And Lucas with the rebound, and the Dons last couple times have settled for the three instead of taking it to the hole, and that's what's gotten them the lead. Oh, beautiful play there. Colby Best with the assist, and Francisco with the basket. He just passed it to him and cut to the basket. One of the oldest plays in basketball, give and go. 16-13. Mules have scored 6 points in a row. It was 16-7. Don still got their starters out there. Barton's open for three in the corner. In, now back in. That's two for Clay Barton, the two threes, and he's got 8 points here in the first quarter. And they tried to run the same play again. This time Francisco wasn't open. Leach open at the head of the key for three, and it's good. That's 5 points for him. And teams trade three-pointers there. We're on pace for a high score here if it stays this way. Still a minute 40 to go. And Barton open again for three, and it's good again. He's off to one of those starts. He's got 11, and it's 22-16. A minute and a half to go in the first quarter. Francisco dribbles into the front court to Best, and he lobs it down to McCain just outside the right block. And Brad Eddins is going to pick up an over-the-back foul. It's going to be four team fouls on the Dons as Brandon Patterson and Trent Lippold come in for the Dons. And we have LaRue and Harder checking out. And Leach checks out for Poplar Bluff, and Rodney Houston comes back in. Inbounds pass to Lucas right around the basket. He muscles it up, no good. And what a rebound by Trent Lippold, the freshman. Good defense and a good rebound there by the freshman. Patterson gives it to Martin, now right side to Eddins. Eddins cross court to Moe. He's open for a three-pointer. Looks good, and it is. What a start for the Dons. 25-16, a minute to go in the first quarter. 9-point lead as Lucas has got it, and he's going to fire three, try to answer back, and he does. He's already got 10 points. And we got 50 seconds to go. We'll see if the Dons go for one shot here. They a lot of times when it gets under a minute, they'll go for one shot. And looks like they're going to do that. They're playing catch out way outside here. Patterson's got it now. He'll give it back to Barton. Now over to Lucas Moe. Eddins comes out and picks up the ball near the center court circle. They're going to run their little delay game here and hopefully take care of the basketball and get the last shot. And that way they'll be assured of leading here at the end of the first quarter. They lead 25-19 over the Poplar Bluff Mules as the clock winds down to 15 seconds. We get down to about 10, and Barton will get the ball back. And well, he's got it right now with 10. He's got to go here. He dribbles into the paint, kicks it out. Lippold jumper from the baseline, no good. Patterson with the rebound. He throws it up, and no good. But a good first quarter for the Dons. They lead the Poplar Bluff Mules 25-19 at the end of one quarter here at the Bill O'Reilly Gymnasium. Crowd on their feet here. 25-19, the Dons up by six. We'll be back in 1 minute on KYEC 88.3 FM. Well, the Dons will have the first possession here in the second quarter. They lead the Poplar Bluff Mules 25-19 at the end of one. It'll be Eddins and Patterson, Barton, Moe, and Lippold on the floor. And Barton brings it into the front court. He's guarded by Houston. Gives it to Lucas Moe, deep on the right wing. Moe gets around his man to the baseline, and he goes up, and he's fouled from behind. Francisco, I think, reached around from behind. It should be two shots, but they're not going to call it two shots. So Francisco picks up the foul. That's his second. And it'll be Don's ball underneath their own basket. We'll give you the Mules players on the floor here in just a second. Inbounds pass to Eddins, left baseline. Dribbles back to the wing, down into the paint, all the way to the hole, and a shot blocked. And Francisco comes out with it. Passes ahead, and that is Tyreek Ellis, who's in the game for the first time. Down to Houston on the baseline. Now to Lucas, he's open for a three again, in and out. And the ball's out of bounds off of Brad Eddins. So they've got Francisco, Lucas, Houston, Ellis, and Leach. Ellis, another big guy. Lucas Moe steals the inbounds pass, and he's heading up the floor. Poplar Bluff steals it there, knocks it away from behind, and almost made a great play there. It was Rodney Houston, but they say he stepped on the end line. Well, the Dons will have it down underneath their basket, way out in the corner on the left side. Ball comes inbound to Patterson, and it's knocked out of bounds on a good defensive play there by Tyreek Ellis, the 6'4 junior. Don's still up 25-19. Barton inbound it. Gets it in to Lucas Moe. He'll dribble back to the center of the floor. Barton will come and get, and they'll reset the offense. Barton dribbles over towards the right side, gives it to Moe on the wing. Out front to Patterson. Now left side, Moe cutting to the basket, goes up, and Lucas comes off his man and blocks the shot. That's a good deal, though. I mean, I like to see him taking it. And Leach with a little floater, no good, but he's fouled. As he is. He can get on that floor in a hurry with them long strides. That foul was on Brandon Patterson, his first. That's five team fouls, but nobody has more than one for the Dons. Ellis, two for two at the line. And he makes the free throw. Or excuse me, Leach. Marcidas Leach, not Ellis. That makes it 25-20. Dons still leading by five. Leach with one more free throw. And this one's good as well. And we got Austin LaRue coming back in the ballgame for the Dons. And he's going to replace Lucas Moe. So Poplar Bluff's 5 out of 6 at the free throw line. LaRue inbounds the ball to Patterson in the back court. Hands it two back to LaRue, and LaRue will bring it into the front court. He gets around Leach, gives it out in the corner to Lippold. Back to LaRue on the wing. Now to Patterson, and he calls Barton. Barton gets it as Leach went for the steal. And a good defense there by Houston. He didn't let Barton get that shot off. Brad Eddins bounces down on the block to LaRue. LaRue back to Eddins, out front to Barton. Long three-pointer, no good. And Lucas with the rebound. Willie Lucas gets it for Poplar Bluff, quickly into the front court. Francisco gives it to Houston. Houston down underneath. Ellis goes up, and it won't go. And Lippold with a rebound for the Dons. Dons haven't scored here this quarter. Played almost 2 minutes after getting 25. And a bad pass from Barton. Goes out of bounds. He tried to hit Brad Eddins coming off a screen. And we got number 35, Colin Steffens, a 6'1 senior, coming in for Willie Lucas. And also, you know, Steven Anderson getting ready to check in for the first time. Leach calls for a screen. Double team. Down low. Pretty pass from Francisco. Reverse layup. Up and good by Ellis. And Poplar Bluff coming back here. It's 25-23. Coach Durden was really getting in their face pretty good there between quarters. And they've come out a little different here in the second quarter. Austin LaRue gives the ball to Brandon Patterson. 5:40 to go in the first half. Dons haven't scored here in this quarter. Still lead by two. LaRue gives the ball back to Eddins. And Patterson goes in. Now he kicks it back out. Eddins wide open three. And it's long. Ball tipped around by Patterson. And LaRue gets it, and he's fouled by Rodney Houston. He picks up his first. And that's team foul number four. We got Moe and Harder coming back in for the Dons. Patterson and Lippold comes out. Francisco also comes out, and Best comes back in for Poplar Bluff with Anderson. Mo has it out front here with 5:20 to go in the half. Barton has it on the wing now. Harder comes out to set a screen. Pick and roll into Harder. He gets bumped back out to LaRue for three, and it's an air ball. And the ball tipped around underneath, and it's going to be saved in by Anderson. Saved it the Best. Lobs up ahead to Leach. He catches and lays it up, and it goes in. What a shot by Leach. Never even put the ball on the floor. Perfect pass from Colby Best. And it's 25 all. And the Dons, after being so hot in the first quarter, we're almost halfway through the second, and they haven't scored. Poplar Bluff has scored six, which is not overly that many for almost a half a quarter, but the Dons haven't scored any. Harder's got it, looking for a cutter. Underneath, LaRue gets it and goes up, and no good, but he's fouled. Number 24, Colby Best, picks up his first. And Austin LaRue will shoot two for the Dons. Trying to give them the lead back. 4.5 minutes left in the half here, and it's 25-25. Now Willie Lucas to the scorer's table to check in, and LaRue misses the free throw. He replaces Colin Steffens. Steffens give Lucas probably a minute and a half break there, and then Lucas right back in the game. LaRue's next one is good. Well, that's 4 points for LaRue. Now the Dons lead by one, 26-25. We've got Anderson bringing it into the front court, bounces to Lucas. Lucas, nice move, and he puts it up and in. He got Harder to bite on the fake. And that's 12 points for Willie Lucas. And Poplar Bluff leads at 27-26 now. Clay Barton calls out play number three, gives it to Justin Harder on the left wing. Now to Eddins at the head of the key. Now to Mole back on the left side. He guarded by Leach. Baseline to Harder. He throws it back out front. Now over on the right side, Eddins gives it to Barton. Poplar Bluff playing a lot better defense. Mo with a little floater up, no good. And we got an offensive foul on Lucas Mo. And that was Tyreek Ellis drew the charge. That's two fouls on Mo. And Poplar Bluff will inbound it, leading by one. Seems like every time I say something about off to a high-scoring game, it slows down. Best in the corner for three, no good. But he's going to get three free throws. He's knocked down by Justin Harder. I think he was behind, yep. That's a bad foul there. You don't never want to foul a guy behind that three-point line. And Colby Best missed it badly, but it may have been because he got hit. I don't know. And he makes first free throw. After missing the first one, Willie Lucas, early in the game, they've made six in a row now. And Coach Carpenter's going to call a timeout with 3:28 left first half. The Mules on top, 28-26. We'll be back after this 30-second timeout on KYEC 88.3 FM. After the timeout, Best will be at the free throw line for Poplar Bluff. He's made the first one. He's still got two more to go. And fouled on a three-point shot. And this one is up and good. That's 2 points for Best. 3:28 to go in the first half. And he misses this one, and Brad Eddins rebounds for the Dons. 29-26. And Steven Anderson with a great play there as he throwed it back inbounds, but Leach couldn't handle it, and the Dons get lucky there that they keep the possession. Bess all over Clay Barton out front. Gives it to Edens. Edens dribbles ahead of the key. Back to Barton. On the right wing. Backs it back out. 3 minutes to go first half. Barton picked up by Anderson. Head of the key to Tanner Buck. Now to LaRue. Back on the wing. Back in the corner to LaRue. Dogs moving it quickly here, which is what they got to do. But now they get it low to LaRue. On the right block, he's double teamed. Back out to Barton. Fall away three. It's good. That's four of them in the first half. He's got 14 points. Ties the game at 29. Anderson calls Lucas out to screen, and he travels with it. As Barton jumped out on him there off his man, or excuse me, Patterson, and he caused the travel. And it'll be Don's ball with a chance to regain the lead here with 2.5 minutes left. Tanner Buck, guarded by Anderson, gives it to Edens. Baseline to LaRue, fakes the shot. Back is swinging around back to Barton at the head of the key. Barton gets a screen from Patterson. Underneath the LaRue ball knocked away, and there's Anderson. Boy, he's got some quick hands, quick feet as well. And he made up for his turnover on the other end, and Leach's going to take it all the way in. And Patterson's going to have to foul him. He's going to try to draw the charge, but Leach sidestepped him. And that team foul number 8, but this is a shooting foul anyway. And Marcidas Leach has got 9 points in the first half. Willie Lucas is leading them with 12. So we've got 21 of the 29, and that's pretty much, according to the stats that Frankie gave me, that's pretty much the way it's been all year long, as they have done most of the scoring. And he makes the first one. And we have Rodney Houston coming back in for Colby Bess for the Mules. 2:04 to go in the first half. Poplar Bluff back up with that free throw, 30-29, and now 31-29. And with 2 minutes left, Austin LaRue brings it into the front court, gives it to Brad Edens on the baseline, dribbles baseline, and he tries to hit Tanner Buck on the in the left corners underneath the basket. He was trying to throw it underneath the basket, and he overshot him out of bounds, so a turnover on the Dons. Anderson brings it across the time box. Buck on him, gets a screen from McCain, reverses his dribble down into the paint, puts the floater up, no good, and Brandon Patterson saves it from going out of bounds. Clay Barton up in the front court to LaRue. Back to Barton. He's hit four threes here in the first half. Tanner Buck drives baseline, and we got a foul as he, I'd rather have the bucket there Patterson got, but they call the foul before the pass. McCain picks it up. His first. Number 20, Peyton Bradley, a 6'2 senior, comes in for the Mules, replaces Steven Anderson. And the Mules, the Don's not in the bonus yet. That was team foul number 6. Inbound pass comes to Patterson. He'll hand it to Clay Barton. Barton comes back between the circles. Don's trailing 31-29. They've only scored 4 points this quarter. Poplar Bluff has got 12. Barton left wing. In the corner to Tanner Buck. Buck bounces to Patterson. Out to Austin LaRue. He's open for three. Harkin shot. And I believe Leach got a hand on it. He runs out to the other end, but they don't get it to him. And a blocking foul on Tanner Buck. And he stepped in front of Rodney Houston after he passed it there. It looked like a charge, but Buck couldn't believe it. And that will send Rodney Houston to the free throw line. And it'll be a 1-1. That team foul number 9 on the Dons here with 56.2 seconds left in the first half. Houston's first trip. And his free throw's up and good. Boy, I tell you what. Better just quit fouling him, that's for sure. 3-point lead. One more coming for Rodney Houston. This one's up, and it's a little long, and Edens gets the rebound. Well, Don's down by 3. We'll see if Coach Carpenter goes for one shot here. Yep, they're gonna, if they can hang on to the ball here, which they haven't turned it over much. LaRue gives the ball to Barton. He's standing in the center court circle there just to cross the half line. Gives it over to Eddins. Down to 30 seconds left. Now LaRue has it. As he and LaRue and Eddins and Barton play catch with it. Down to 25 seconds. Hans going to go for the last shot here. Barton will come and get it. He's guarded by Rodney Houston. 12 seconds to go. Dribbles over to the other side. Hands it to Brad Eddins. Eddins back to Barton. He's got to go. He's down to 6 seconds. And we got a foul, and that's going to put Barton at the free throw line. That foul's on Houston. That's two on him. Clay Barton will be shooting the front end of a one-on-one here. He can pull the Dons within one if he can make two here, but he's got to make the first one. Get the second. 3.5 seconds left. And it's long. Rebounded by Leach. He gets into the front court. He doesn't get it off in time. And that's the end of the first half. And with a good second quarter there, actually a bad second quarter by the Dons, more than a good second quarter for the Mules. But the Dons only trail here 32-29 at the half due to the Poplar Bluff Mules. Dons scored 25 points in the first quarter, but they only got four in that quarter. As they went cold, and Poplar Bluff stepped up the defense a little bit. And Poplar Bluff outscored them 13-4 in the second quarter to take a 32-29 lead. Give it back to me now, Gage. Oh. Well, while we were away, we missed a couple of buckets, one from Tristan Francisco. Lucas Moanser's back at the other end. So the score is 34-31. Poplar Bluff for the ball. Leach with the drive to the basket, and he lays up a little finger roll, and it's good again for the freshman. He's got 13. Dons have Barton and LaRue, and Moe, Eddins, and Harder. They're starters on the floor. Barton's open for three at the head of the key. No good. And Lucas with a rebound. Lucas, Francisco, McCain, Houston, and Leach on the floor for Poplar Bluff. And now Willie Lucas with the little runner, and it's up and good. So Poplar Bluff hitting everything they shoot here. They're 3-for-3 from the field here in the third quarter, and they lead 38-31. That's their biggest lead of the game. Don's got to watch out and not let it slip away here. Give yourselves a chance in the fourth quarter. Brad Eddins at the head of the key. Hands the ball to Moe. Fakes the three. Gets to the free throw line. Elevates. The jumper up and good for Lucas Moe. Moe's got 11. And it's 38-33 Mules. 6:10 to go in the third quarter. Francisco gives it to Houston. Head of the key to Lucas. Long three-pointer up. No good. And the ball is going to go out of bounds, I think. Nope. Barton saves it. I think it would have been out on Poplar Bluff's foot, but Harder out in the corner to Moe. He's open for three, no good. And battling for the rebound there. Harder almost got it. Pass up, out of power. Oh, Eddins missed it. And Lucas is going to take it down and get fouled by Brad Eddins. He had the steal, let it get away. And then Poplar Bluff had a 2-on-1. And back to the free throw line for more free throws. Be Willie Lucas. That was, I believe, the second foul on Eddins. And Lucas misses the free throw. And we got Patterson and Lippold coming in for the Dons. LaRue and Harder check out. And we got Ellis getting ready to come in for Poplar Bluff. Going to replace McCain. And Lucas will have one more free throw. Lucas and Leach both are lefties. And this one no good. And Lippolt with the rebound. He gives it up to Lucas Moe. Out of Patterson, left side to Brad Eddins. Back to Patterson between the circles. And looking for Clay Barton. He's guarded closely by Ellis. And he double-teamed and almost had it stolen, but he does get it back and hands it to Barton. Poplar Bluff really getting after it on defense now. They started that in the second quarter. They didn't, well, I can't say they weren't playing any defense, but Don stole it out of bounds, but the ball's tipped. And it will stay with the Dons. Coach Durden didn't think it got tipped. I thought it was tipped, but kind of looked like it took a little different track there. And the bounce in the middle, stolen away. Lucas to Leach. Leach one-on-one. Now he backs it out behind the three-point line to Lucas. Lucas down low to Houston. Spins into the paint, and we get a foul on the Dons. And it's on Lucas Moe, and that's his third. Lucas has scored the 4 points. The Dons have scored here in the third quarter. Down to 4:55. It's 38-33 Poplar Bluff. Francisco will throw it in. Gets it to Lucas in the corner. Right back to Francisco. Back to Lucas behind the three-point line. He shoots a three. Badly missed it. Then Moe picks it up off the floor. Comes down the left side. Decides to let everybody go by. Gives it to Patterson. He swings it right side to Eddins. Head of the key to Moe. Moe just outside the free throw line. Jumper up and good for Lucas Moe. That makes it 38-35. Don's back within three. 4 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the third quarter. Willie Lucas gives the ball up to Leach. Leach gets a screen from Lucas. Comes back the other way down into the paint. And Brandon Patterson picks up a foul. He is lightning quick. They're going to say it was on the floor. We got Bess and McCain coming back in for Poplar Bluff. And Jordan LaRue coming in for Patterson for the Dons. Lucas and Francisco check out for Poplar Bluff. 4:19 to go, third. And it will be Houston throws it in out front to Leach. Leach crossover dribble down into the paint. Finger roll up and good. 40-35. I don't think any Dons don't have anybody to guard him man-to-man. Jordan LaRue gives the ball to Clay Barton. He'll dribble into the front court against the pressure from Rodney Houston. Right side, it goes to Brad Eddins. Now back to Barton. Back to Lucas Moe. Moe looking for the cutter, nobody open. Back to Eddins at the head of the key. Left side to LaRue. Now to Barton as the Dons run a motion offense. Eddins gets a pass to the basket, drops it off to Lippolt. Out front to LaRue. Left side. Dons pass around the perimeter until Moe takes it into the paint. Gives it out to LaRue on the baseline. He doesn't want to shoot it. Back out front. Now to Eddins on the left side. Jordan LaRue's got it. In the corner, Lucas Moe. He's going to fire three in and out. Ball tipped around, and Eddins tips it up, and he's fouled, and he'll get two shots as he was in the act of tipping it in. And it's going to be on Rodney Houston. And I think that's his third. And Eddins will go to the free throw line. 3:22 to go in the third quarter. Poplar Bluff leads by five, 40-35. Eddins' free throw is good. Lucas and Anderson come back in. And it'll be McCain and Houston checking out. Brad Eddins' first point of the game. Trying to get the Dons back within three of the Mules, and he does. 40-37. Dons can hang around about fourth quarter. You never know what might happen. Anderson gives it to Leach. Bounces to Lucas. He works his way in. Fall away jumper up and good. Boy, he's got a soft touch. Lucas Moe's going to dribble it up against the press. And Leach all over him, but he gets it into the front court. Jordan LaRue gives it to Brad Eddins. Eddins now to Barton. They've done a pretty good job of guarding Barton, but he takes it to the hole, puts it up, and won't go. But he'll go to the free throw line. Almost had a chance for a three-point play, but it was shot. Just wouldn't quite fall. And that one's on Colby Bess, his second. first one goes through. He's got 15. 2:47 left in the third quarter. Trying to get the Dons back within three again, and nothing but net. And we got Brandon Patterson coming back in for the Dons, and Jordan LaRue checks out. Getting hot in here. Anderson will bring it into the front court. Dons have gone to a zone. I believe it's the first time tonight they've played a zone. Bess gives it to Lucas on the right wing behind the three-point line. Cross court, Leach. He's open for three. It's good. My goodness. Barton brings it into the front court. Dons down by six again. Lucas Moe on the left wing. Gives it to Barton. Now to Eddins. Eddins takes it into the paint. Goes in. Shot up on goal. And rebound by Lucas. Good drive there, but couldn't finish the shot. Leach dribbles baseline. Stops and pops too hard. And Eddins and Lippold almost lost the rebound, but Eddins brings it into the front court. Gives it to Patterson. Hands it off to Barton. Barton stops and pops a three, and it's good. 19 for Barton, 45-42 Mules. 1:40 to play in the third quarter. Lucas deep on the left wing. Puts it on the floor, goes inside the three-point line, and puts it in from about 18. If you get up too close to him, he'll drive around you, and if you lay off on him, he'll hit the jump shot. That time he put it on the floor and got just inside the three-point line. 47-42. Mules with 1:15 to go. And the Dons are going to run the delay game here with over a minute to go. Coach Carpenter trying to keep it close heading to that fourth quarter, I guess. They still got a minute and 5 seconds before the end of the quarter. Now, if somebody would happen to slip open underneath the basket, they might take it. But don't watch out. They'll get a offensive foul here setting the screen if they don't watch out. Patterson double team. Cross court, and Leach almost intercepted it, but Patterson having trouble. Gets it to Barton with 40 seconds left. Over to Lucas Moe. Moe holds it on his hip, gives the ball to Eddins now, and Eddins will give it to Barton with 30 seconds left. We'll run down a minute and 15 seconds here to go in for the last shot. Dons trail 47-42. Got 15 seconds. Barton hands it to Lucas Moe now. A little clear out for Moe. Moe down into the paint, off to Lippold, out to Barton, wide open. No, he didn't take it. Takes it in, out to Moe for three from the head of the key, and it's no good. Barton rebounds, puts it up, and no good. And that's the end of the third quarter, and the Poplar Bluff Mules still on top of the Dons, 47-42. We'll be back after this 1 minute timeout with more Dons basketball on KYEC. Keith Bowman back at Bill L. Wright Gymnasium. We start the fourth quarter here. The Dons trailing the Poplar Bluff Mules 47-42. Coach Carpenter sends out Brad Eddins, Clay Barton, Brandon Patterson, Trent Lippold, and Lucas Moe. And Poplar Bluff has Houston, Steffens, Bess, Lucas, and Francisco. Barton gives it to Lucas Moe, hounded by Francisco, right up in his shorts with him. Into the key to Lippold. Now right side to Edens. They lob to Lippold. He catches it and lays it. Oh, he tipped it too hard. Perfect play right off the bat here, but Lippold tipped it just a little too hard. A beautiful pass from Lucas Moe. Well, they needed that one there. They'd held by five. Now Poplar Bluff's got it back, and the Dons have gone back to a man-to-man. Colby Best, left wing. Hits Steffens at the free throw line. Out to Francisco on the right wing. He bounces down low, and Lucas Moe almost stole it, but he couldn't quite keep it in bounds. And it's a good thing that he didn't, because he daved it right into Francisco, and he was going to shoot a layup. And Best checks out, and Leach comes back in. So they got Leach and Lucas both on the floor now. Inbounds pass comes to Steffens. Houston with a drive to the basket, and he lays it up and in. Strong move there by, Houston. And lead back to seven. 7 minutes to go in the ball game. Patterson bounces to Lucas Moe. He's double teamed down on the baseline. Out to Barton. He's going to fire three, and it's good. That's 22 for Clay Barton. 49-45 Mules. Leach back at the other end. A fall-away three. No good. That wasn't a very good shot. And Lippold with another rebound for the Dons. Dons with a chance to cut into that lead a little bit. Patterson gives it to Moe. Moe with a pass to the basket. He lays it up, and Steffens blocks it out of bounds. A good drive there by Lucas, but better job by Steffens to block the shot. 6:32 left in the ball game. Mules leading the Dons 49-45. Inbounds pass to Moe at the head of the key. Francisco on him, dribbles into the paint, goes up with a shot, no good, but we got a foul. And that's going to be before the shot, and Francisco may have twisted his ankle. And he did, and he's going to have to get some help off the floor. His teammates there must have come down on somebody's foot. He's going to make it all by himself, but Colby Best will replace him. Also, Tyreek Lewis in for Steffens. And Edens will inbound for the Dons. Into Moe. Moe takes it in right into the defense, and they're going to call a jump ball as Colby Best got his hand on that ball on the shot going up. And it'll be Poplar Bluff basketball. Leach at 6'5", bringing the ball up the floor. He's done it quite a bit tonight for Poplar Bluff. Dribbles over to the right side. Now gives it to Houston. Houston dribbles to the left wing. Down low. Muscling it up and in is Leach. And he can score inside or out either one. He's got 20 now. Lucas has got 18, Leach has got 20. Back at the other end, Moe hands it to Barton. Now he gives it to Edens on the left baseline. On the wing to Moe, he takes it in, little finger roll up and good. 15 for Lucas Moe, 51-47. Dons need to get a stop here and score, make it a little closer. Moe on Leach, Leach left wing, out front to Best. Now to Houston. Houston hands it to Lucas on the baseline. Over to Ellis, and he shoots a jumper, no good. Offensive rebound by Houston. He put it up, no good. Tipped up again, no good. And finally, Lippold comes out with it for the Dons. I tell you what, Lippold's growing up before our very eyes here on the varsity. I'm telling you what, sometimes I think he plays better on the varsity than he does on the JV. Patterson, left side to Edens. To Barton, three-pointer, in and out. And Dons can't get any closer than that four. 51-47. Poplar Bluff with the ball with 4:55 left in the ballgame. Leach gives it to Lucas. Right back to Leach. Gets a screen. Back to Lucas. He's open for three on the left side. No good. And the ball tipped around, and we're going to have a holding foul on Bess. I mean, on Brad Edens as he was holding Bess. And that's three on Edens. And 14 fouls on the Dons. 4:45 to go in the ballgame. Poplar Bluff leading 51-47. The Dons got a shot here. And we got a timeout. We'll take one, too. We'll be back after this one-minute break on KYEC 88.3 FM. Stay with us.
knew if they played like they did Friday night. If I knew if they played like they did Friday night, it'd be a good game. They played pretty much that way, like they did Friday.
Poplar Bluff gets the inbounds pass into McCain at the right elbow of the free throw line, and wide open underneath is Tyreek Ellis, but Patterson fouls him, kept him making the basket, but sends him to the free throw line, and he misses the free throw. Ellis has got 2 points at Poplar Bluff after going 9 out of 12 in the first half, 0 for 3 this half from the free throw line. 51-47, Poplar Bluff leads, 4:36 left in the ballgame. Ellis' next one, no good, and he jumped over the free throw line too quick. That's the second time tonight Poplar Bluff's done that. Justin Harder comes in and replaces Trent Lippold, and he ought to get a big hand from the Don's fans here. He's done a great job. And the Don's with it again, trying to cut that four-point lead down a little bit. They've had a few cracks at it and hadn't been able to do it. Got another chance now. Barton gets it to Moe, gets around his man into the paint, out in the corner to Harder. He's cut off on the baseline. Now he's going to shoot the jumper, and it won't go. Round and out. And again, he had just checked into the game. Usually the coach wants you to work up a little sweat before you shoot a shot, but he was open. It just wouldn't go. Houston dribbles baseline underneath, and he had no chance of making that shot, and the Dons bail him out. He was underneath the basket, and no way he could have got the shot up. Justin Harder picks up the foul, and that will send him to the free throw line again for 2 shots. That's the second one on Harder. And the Dons now have 16 fouls, so Poplar Bluff will shoot free throws the rest of the game. And wouldn't you know it, the Dons didn't take advantage of the other end again, and they come back to this end and score. That's 4 points for Rodney Houston. And this one no good, and Patterson rebounds. So it's a 5-point lead. We're halfway through the fourth quarter. Barton, Leach all over him out near midcourt. Gives it to Lucas Moe. Now to Edens at the head of the key. Dribbles to the elbow, gives it to Moe. Moe will give it back to Barton, and they reset here with 3:45 to go in the game. Over to Patterson. Now to Moe down on the baseline. To Barton, fake the three. Going to take it in. He'll put it up, and the shot blocked by Ellis. And it goes out of bounds. Got to keep taking it in there, though. I know that shot was blocked, but you got to keep taking it in there. They're going to foul you sometimes. A little head fake might do wonders, too. I don't know. Barton open in the corner. Three-pointer, and it's good again. That's 25 for Clay Barton, and it's 52-50. Don's trail by two. With 3:20 left in the game, Leach at the other end takes it to the baseline, cut off by Edens, throws it out to Houston on the wing. And Brad Edens steals it. Leach is behind him, goes in, lays it up, and he's fouled by Marcinkus Leach. And Edens done a nice job protecting the ball there. And with 3:11 to go, Brad Edens can tie the ball game at 52 if he can make a couple of free throws. I was waiting to see the way the Dons played on Friday night if they could come out and do it again against Poplar Bluff, and they've done it here. No matter the outcome, they've played really good, and Edens misses the free throw. Colby Best back in the game for Rashawn McCain. 3:11 to go. He can still make it a 1-point game. Next one up and good. And it's 52-51. 3 minutes, 8 seconds left in the game. Houston into the front court to Bess on the right wing. Down low to Lucas. That's the first time he's touched the ball in a while. And Patterson flopped there trying to draw a charge. He left Lucas wide open. He laid it in. Now Lucas has got 20, and Leach has got 20. Back to a three-point lead. Going to the three-minute mark. Martin over to Patterson. Patterson dribbles in, almost traveled, gets his man in the air, goes up, and it's blocked by Bess. Not a good shot there. Bess at the other end is going to stop and pop, and it's good, and he's fouled by Moe. And that hurts. Well, that's four on Moe, but what hurts more is the bucket and the foul. And that'll give Colby Bess a chance to make an old-fashioned three-point play. 2:33 to go. And it is 56-51, Poplar Bluff. That was only Bess's first field goal. He's got 4 points. He was very close to being behind the three-point line there, but I guess he was just a little inside it. I mean, that probably, Coach Durden probably was hollering, "Don't shoot that," but it went in. Because they was kind of out on a semi-fast break there. And there wasn't a couple of Don's players and one Poplar Bluff player down there, so the Don's probably would have got the rebound. But anyway, it's 2:33 to go in the ballgame. And Bess trying to get the old-fashioned three-point play and give Poplar Bluff a six-point lead again. Leach and Lucas have 40 of their 56 points. And Bess makes the free throw. He checks out, and Peyton Bradley comes in for him. 2:33 to go. Don's, what they got to do here is not get in no hurry. They still got a lot of time left. They're going to rush in three-pointers and end up getting beat by 15 again because Poplar Bluff will make them free throws. Moe takes it in, stops and pops, and good again from about 8 feet. 57-53. We'll see what Poplar Bluff does here as we near the two-minute mark. And Leach is going to take it all the way in and lay in the finger roll. And the Dons just absolutely have nobody that can guard him. That's just all they are to it. Back to a six-point lead, 2 minutes to go. Barton double teamed, his pass batted away, and it goes out of bounds, and it'll be off of Marcidas Leach. And with 1:56 to go, Clay Barton will inbound for the Dons. Gets it into Lucas Moe. 59-53, Poplar Bluff. Moe guarded out front by Ellis. Gives it to Brad Eddins. Eddins into the paint, goes in, shot up, won't go, but he's fouled. And that's good. He gets a chance to score with the clock not running. That foul on Peyton Bradley. And two shots coming for Brad Eddins. He's got 3 points all from the free throw line tonight. And it's good. Bess comes back in for Bradley. 59-54, 1:44 left in the fourth quarter. Eddins' next one, also good. Leach didn't try to stall the ball last time down the floor. Houston's got it out front, Barton on him. Loses his dribble, and Coach Durden calls a timeout with 1:34 to go. And the Mules on top, 59-55. We'll take a 30-second break, and we'll be back after this message. Folks, I hope that you haven't just tuned in because you have missed a good one if you have. And the Don's trail here, 59-55 to the Poplar Bluff Mules. And we'll wait till this timeout's over to see him. I think it was 1:32 or 1:33 left in the ballgame. It's going to be Poplar Bluff's ball. And 1:34 left in the game. It's 59-55. Poplar Bluff had a real high-scoring first quarter, but since then, the scoring has calmed down quite a bit by both teams. Inbounds pass comes to Leach in the backcourt. He's guarded by Lucas Moe. And he'll bring it into the front court. We'll see if Poplar Bluff keeps taking the ball to the basket or keeps shooting. Leach, a long three-pointer. It's good. Holy smokes. You would think they would be stolen the ball, but he has got 25 points, and he is quite the freshman, I'm telling you. 1:10 to go. Harder screens. Moe takes it to the right side. And he lost it, but Edmonds is there to pick it up. Takes it in the paint, stripped away, ball loose on the floor. And it's still loose. And still loose, and Poplar Bluff finally comes up with it. Well, that's probably just about going to do it. There's 50 seconds left, and it's 62-55, and Leach, pick and roll, knocked away, but it goes right back to Leach, and he takes it in and lays it up. In with the right hand. I mean, the Poplar Bluff's definitely getting all the breaks here at the end, too. That one, the Dons did a good job defending the pick and roll, but they couldn't come up with the basketball. They knocked it away, and Leach took it in to score, make it 64-55. We got a timeout, but we'll keep it here and let you know that our next game that we'll have on KYEC here, 88.3 FM, Thursday night at 7:45, the Donettes will be playing Maynard Lady Tigers, Maynard, Arkansas, down at the Corning First National Bank Invitational Tournament. And if they win that game, they'll play at 7:45 on Friday night, most likely against Corning. And if you'll remember, Donettes lost to Corning earlier in the year here at Doniphan. In a game that, well, there's just absolutely no way they should have lost it. That's all there was to it. But that'll be our next broadcast, 7:45 Thursday night. Well, the Don's got 41 seconds here, and they trail by 9. So, and Poplar Bluff's going to put some full court pressure on, makes them use up some time getting it to the other end. Inbounds pass comes to Brad Evans. He holds on his hip. He's got to go here. Brings it into the front court. He's guarded by Houston. It's Barton. He's open for a three. Been hitting them all night. He missed that one. And the ball loose on the floor. And Harder picks it up, and he's fouled by Rashawn McCain. Both guys hustling after the basketball. That was kind of a bad break there for McCain. And still no 1-1. That's only 16 fouls. Inbounds to Barton. He's open for three in the corner. In and out. Both of those last two he shot went in and out. And they foul Houston in the backcourt. I don't think I would have done that. And it's 64-55 and probably just going to make the score worse. So it is just going to be a 1-1. That was team foul number 8. And Rodney Houston, he's got 4 points. 64-55. Looks like the Don's going to come up a little short, but they gave it a gallant effort here tonight. Houston gets the first one. He has 5 points. Poplar Bluff's going to be awfully, awfully, awfully tough next year. Pretty good right now. Both free throws good. Makes it 66-55 as Barton's going to fire three. Blocked from behind by Leach. And the ball is going to be kicked out of bounds by Houston with 11.8 seconds to go. So Poplar Bluff's going to win it here. It's just a matter of what the score is going to be. But like I said, the Don's played a really good game here tonight against a really good team. Barton fakes the three. His man flies by him, shoots a three, no good. And Best rebounds, and the Don's don't need to foul. Patterson fouls him. I don't know why in the world you foul right there with 3.6 seconds to go. What that does is give them a chance to make the score worse than what it is. I guess if you lose, it doesn't make any difference, but. It's going to be Colby Best at the free throw line. He's got 5 points. So it was mostly the Marcedes Leach and Willie Lucas show. And the second half here, Leach has got 16. Lucas only has 8 in the second half. That free throw, no good. Moe with the rebound, throws it up from midcourt, and no good. And a final score is the Poplar Bluff Mules 66, and the Doniphan Dons 55.